Assalamu alaikum and very good morning grade 6. Today we'll do page number 98 till 101 and we'll do question number 245 and the topic is livers. Okay?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Okay students, in lecture number 2 of unit number 9, Forces and Machines, let us revise the basic facts. A force is a push or pull which changes the size, shape or speed of an object. A machine is a device for making work easier by either changing the size and direction of a force or by producing a large movement from a smaller movement. There are six simple machines: the lever, the ramp or inclined plane, the wedge, the screw, the wheel and axle, and the pulley. The six simple types of machines can be combined to make more complex machines. These were the four basic facts that we have studied in lecture number 1. But in this lecture, we are going to read this one. A lever is a bar that turns on a pivot called a fulcrum to exert a force. An effort applied at one point on the lever can move a load at another point. Levers are grouped into three types depending on the position of the effort, load, and fulcrum. At page number 98, we are watching that a tree branch can be used as a lever, and this clever trick was used thousands and thousands of years ago by ancient man. That's why I think levers are the earliest machine that were discovered by man. Okay. Now, what is a lever? A lever consists of a rigid arm which is free to turn about a point called the fulcrum. The fulcrum is a pivot. The effort, force, push or pull acts on one end of the lever and the other end goes up or down in the opposite direction like a seesaw. Technically speaking, lever consists of a rigid arm or rigid rod which is free to turn about a point. That point is called fulcrum. Okay, here this blue point is fulcrum. Okay, now the fulcrum is a pivot. The force that we are applying is called effort and the work done by this rod is called load. See, effort is shown with orange highlighter, fulcrum is shown with orange highlighter, and here the load definition is shown with green highlighter. Okay, the load tends to move the lever in the opposite direction to the force of push or pull. So students, the board is ready to understand the main thing of lever. Okay, now I'm showing here what is the key to learn these three classes of lever. So first class is Eiffel. Okay, Eiffel Tower, have you heard this name? So think in mind and see EFL. Think in mind that first class is EFL, means F fulcrum is in the center, effort is at one side and load is at the other side. Now second will be elf. You know na elf, it's a magical creature. So second type is elf, where load is in the center, okay, fulcrum is at the side. And the third type is leaf. Think just leaf, okay, and effort is in the middle. So it is the key to learn it quickly. Now EFL, EFL, first class. Okay, if the effort will be there at a side and fulcrum will be in the center, then this will be first class of lever. Okay, and if the second class is there, then it will be elf, load will be in the center. And if it is left, means effort is in the center, then it will be third class. Got it? This is the easiest thing I could tell you. First class of lever has following examples. Okay, EFL, what was EFL? So the examples are pliers, claw hammer, scissors and box opener. In all these four types, F is in the center, fulcrum is in the center, and What are the features? The load is greater than the effort, then this is called a force magnifier. The effort moves further than the load. The fulcrum is nearer to the load than the effort to increase the turning effect of the force or of the effort. Force and effort, same thing. Okay, now we will move to second class of lever. Okay, what was the key? Elf, the magical creature. What was the key? Elf. So you can see that here the second class is elf. Effort, load is in the center, fulcrum is at the side. Elf. Can you see what are the examples of second class of lever? Wheelbarrow, nutcracker, bottle opener, paper cutter. Four examples. Elf. Now the third class is the leaf. What is that? Leaf. E is in the center. Okay. I forgot to tell you the main features. It is also second class is also the force magnifier, but here you can see it is a little different. The effort moves a shorter distance, but the load moves a greater distance. A large force is used to move a small load. That's why this third class of lever is creating larger movement, but it is not a force magnifier. Okay. The example, what was the sequence you have to learn? Lift. Effort is in the center. Okay. So human arm, fishing rod, and stapler are the example of third class.
Let's start our exercise. We have to do question number 2. Write this way neatly with blue marker. Using a crowbar or some other lever to move a large log is easier than lifting it with your hands. Does this mean that because of this you are doing less work? Explain your answer. The answer is using a crowbar or some other lever to move a large log is making use of turning effect of forces to produce a large force. This does not mean that you're doing less work, because work is force multiplied by distance. In this case, you're using a small force but moving it over a greater distance. Now, question number 4 is, what is meant by effort and load when we talk about levers? The effort is the force that you apply to a simple machine such as a lever to move the resisting force called the load. So the resisting force is the load, the work that you are doing. Okay? This is the technical diagram of all class type of levers. FL, first class, ELF, second class, LEF, third class. Okay? Question number 5 is, describe some advantages and disadvantages of each of the 3 levers. The answer is, the advantages of a first class lever are that it produces a large force from a small force. To achieve this, the fulcrum is further from the effort than the load. This increases the turning effect of the effort. The disadvantage is that the effort has to be moved a longer distance than the load moves. Now give the second heading. A second class lever also produces a large force from a small force. To achieve this, the load is between the fulcrum and the effort increase. This increases the turning effect of the effort. Again, the effort has to be moved a longer distance than the load moves. Okay, now we will write the third paragraph. In a third class lever, the effort is between the fulcrum and the load. This produces a large movement from a small movement, in that the effort moves a shorter distance but the load moves a longer distance. The disadvantage is large force is to be applied for small load movement. Hope you all have written these answers in your journals. Learn them well. Take care. Allah Hafiz.